Hey folks, Sirdar here, and in this episode of Dev with Sirdar, we're going to take a look at some of the new features that have been introduced in Python 3.12, which is now out in beta. There's a lot that's new in 3.12, and it's so much that I'm going to actually need a couple of videos to talk about it. So in this video, I'm going to talk specifically about two big improvements that have been made. One of them is to error messages, and the other is to the Python fstring system. Now, in previous versions of Python, we got revamped error messages that are now more explicit. They tell us exactly what part of a statement is generating an error, and they give us much more useful advice about how to fix it. And in 3.12, many of those improvements now focus on the names for things. For instance, let's say I try to invoke something that needs an import, and I forget the actual import. Python will make suggestions about that. In 3.12, those suggestions have been improved to also come from Python's standard library, as well as any third-party libraries that are present, which was introduced previously. So here's an example of how this works. If I want to do something with the standard library module functools, I have to import it first. So this new error message will hint at the fact that I have to do that. Now this also applies to name errors for things that are within standard library modules too. So let's say I import functools and then I ask for functools.cache, but I forget the E. So if I run this, it will ask if I mean functools.cache with the E, which is correct, and this allows me to fix that mistake. There's also another common beginner's mistake with imports that now gets flagged and corrected. If I type import x from y and I run that, that's obviously an error. But now the error will tell me, do I mean from y import x, which is correct. Another set of useful error improvements involves classes and class members. If I have a name error inside of a class, Python will make suggestions that include the class's attributes. So in this case, if I type speed instead of self.speed, which is what I really meant, Python will ask me, is that in fact what you meant? Did you mean self.speed? So we have better errors, more explicit errors for how things can go wrong inside a class. Now the next big category of useful improvements in 3.12 is changes to the way fstrings behave. Fstrings in Python are ways to format variables inside a string. And previously in Python, when you made an fstring, there were some major restrictions on the expression contents of fstrings. For instance, when you made an fstring, you always had to match the outer quotes. You couldn't use the same quotes on the outside of the string that you could on the inside. So if you opened a string with a double quote, you couldn't use double quotes anywhere else inside the fstring, even inside an expression. You also couldn't include things like backslashes and line breaks inside expressions. You couldn't use Unicode character identifiers. So an fstring like the one I'm showing here, all of this would fail for a lot of reasons. But with 3.12, fstring expressions can now contain any valid Python expression. So things like backslashes, Unicode escape sequences, expressions that are broken across multiple lines, comments, strings using the same quote type, all of this stuff is now valid inside an fstring expression. And by the way, this last one, using the same quote type over again, is probably the most useful because if we open a string with a double quote, we can then reuse double quotes anywhere inside. And on top of that, we can nest quotes. So fstring expressions can be nested indefinitely, like this. Previously, we would have had to render this out as a separate string and then combine it into a single fstring, and now we can do it all in one line, all in a single expression. Another handy thing is that if you make a mistake inside an fstring, for instance, if we forget to define this variable, you will get a precise error message. It will show you exactly inside the string where the error was. Previously, the error message would just be confined to the beginning of the string as the source of the error, and then you had to puzzle things out from your own on there. So that's a really big improvement. Now, in coming videos, I'm going to look at some more Python 3.12 features, like the improved buffer protocol and changes to Python's type hinting system, which has been expanded by leaps and bounds with every successive version of Python. So that's it for now. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev with Sirdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.